tell the world with your blank pages and your microphones. Go remember their faces and press record to break their hearts. Let's make this last forever. Let's make this last forever.
Well, now that Josh's meeting can begin.
Oh, good.
What are you guys talking about today?
were just talking about your songs and how they are personal and real, and how this album kind of took you guys a while to, you know, kind of get it out there. Mm-hmm. And like, does it ever get nerve-wracking kind of doing something so real and honest? And are you always like afraid of the feedback and the criticism and like what?
You know what? There was, if you asked me that 2 weeks ago, I would say yes. As weird as that is, but I just wrote an email to somebody, Allison from Spotify, for over 1 billion views.
Yeah.
Let's go. I wrote an email and it didn't take a minute. But yeah, it was just saying, like, thank you to the concert for participating. Yeah, and what a crazy concept it was that somehow we're at 20 million views for this song that is, you know, it's RV or something. And it somehow has been heard over a million times. It's about to be heard over a million times.
I tweeted something about it the other day. I told you that the song we demoed out 3 years ago in the second story of CrossFit.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
it's literally heard. not just viewed, like heard a million times this way. Like that's the thing that blows my mind. It's like, you know, people that song's been heard.
I don't think that feeling is ever gonna go away.
No.
Have a lot of people reach out to you about the song? Like
that was like the big thing right away that kinda hit people was the fact that it was about what it was about. Mm-hmm. And then you know, unfortunately many things have happened since then, and I guess it kind of, even if it's just a shred, maybe brought some light to how weird the, you know, TV broadcast can be. How, you know, they're trying to divide us, and, you know, at every single turn, like, you know, like it feels like so.
It ended up rolling over into a lot of different events, which is cool in a way, I guess. Maybe not.
I'm not going into too much detail. It's exactly why I got out of journalism. My first degree was in journalism, and
really,
that song exactly is why I walked away.
There you go.
Wow.
Yeah. And now there you are.
So you have,
now I'm a boring college professor.
And you have the insight. That. That's amazing.
I am.
That's cool. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yep. It's exactly why I walked away.
Yeah, we're ours is like a 50,000 foot view of it. Mm-hmm. Yours is like an actual face to face.
Yeah. It was a literal moment like that, and I was like, I can't do this. I quit.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that's great.
I can feel it.
Cheers to you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, thanks.
We're the honest ones. I like it.
So you guys talk about how the name of your band, you want to bring like musicianship and true, like strong live performances. Do you think that's missing from like rock music now?
A little bit. That's like, sort of like a safe answer.
I think it's more.
No, let's not be safe. Like, why do you think that's missing now?
There's so many people depend on, like, you know, the radio success, obviously, but there comes a point where it's like you're just a radio band almost. It's like there's so much production and so much writing that's not even done by bands, things like that. And it's not that we're like, judging people for that, but it's just that, like, if you go too far down that path, it's like, are you really an authentic artist? Or is
rock has become way too corporate.
Yeah, absolutely. As hipster as that sounds.
Let me drink my PBR.
We're all ridiculous.
Somebody bring me my knitted hat.
That is true.
Who does most of the writing?
It's pretty split up. I think the best things we've ever wrote, like What a Feeling and Save the Queen, came from like just spending 2 days in a studio and drinking together and laughing. And literally just sitting in a room until those songs were done. And I really like the way that like kind of writing is done, but like it's also like Sammy might have an idea and bounce it off Josh and like bounce it off me here. Like it's very collective and it's a nice one.
Yeah, there's no wrong way to do it.
Yeah.
That's the important mindset to have, I think, for like young bands for sure. It's like I've listened to so many interviews with some of my favorite artists, and they're always just like, well, this is how we write, and that like corrupted me when I was younger. I'd be like, why do I write like that?
Yeah.
And it's like, really, it's just like, that's not true. We don't have to do it at all. There's no right or wrong way to do it.
Especially like, we kind of got to a point where we didn't want to restrict like the way anything came out, you know? So like, we've got a bunch of demos that are kind of even almost pushing in like a different genre, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, they didn't make the album, but like, you can't. We just like really made a point to like not restrict like creativity, you know, just like completely
let whatever comes out,
and then decide later, you know.
Yeah. Maybe we'll see someone out on another album.
Hopefully, yeah.
We have a lot of music.
Yeah. You're the newest member, right?
You're the newest member?
You're the car, you
guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
What were you doing when you joined the band?
Let's see. Well, it was my first year of college, actually.
Where
so
were you
I
going?
I went to college at U of M, University of Michigan.
Oh, wait.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I know. I studied music there in the jazz program, but yeah, I was playing with a bunch of bands from people I knew in like high school and other people at my school, and Sammy saw me play with some friends of his, because we had a little group at the time, so we were just playing something like that, all the bands, the name or something, just rocking out and stuff, and then when the time came that they needed someone, he just gave me a call, and it ended up working out fine, but yeah, that was kind of crazy. I kind of walked into it like just when things were starting. I think it was like the second or third show was like one of our showcases for the label.
His first show was like a sold out show.
And you talked on stage?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
I got a few
rehearsals in, so I was felt okay. But yeah,
it was what did your mother say?
Oh, she
what country did you say? That's like, I'm actually kind of looking
at it. Both of you kind of. I mean, like, you know.
Yeah.
Sam's mom, she loves it.
Both my parents actually went to music school as well, so they've done the musician thing, so they're not totally uncomfortable with it, like a lot of some parents do, but yeah, they're totally supportive, and they're like, yeah, they're great, so I've never had any problems with, like, you know, being yelled at for going out to be a...
I'm a college professor, and so it's like, dropping out of college.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm like, what are you doing?
I'm throwing your life away.
Yeah.
That's good.
Okay. Cheers and throw your life.
I love it. I meant all four dropping out of University of Michigan. You were going nowhere.
Yeah, that degree would have been
exactly. Nothing. You would have gotten nothing.
This talk hurts my heart. I can't wait to listen.
Kidding. All right. So I don't know that we have a lot more time. I think you guys got to kind of get ready to.
Sound.
Actually play. Yes. But thanks for spending some time with us. Absolutely. Really, I love the CD. I can't wait to see what else you guys got on. I love how engaged you are with the crowd. I love it every time I see you live.
Excited. You guys are gonna hang out all night, right?
Absolutely. We're gonna hang out.
I just learned a new line. I just did an interview over here at the Blitz, and we're talking about what's your worst stage thing you've ever said live.
He goes, okay, on the count of three, we're all going to say what we're thankful for the night before Thanksgiving. He goes, 1, 2, I don't fucking care.
Well,
anyway, I said it for
they just said a darkness, the coolest thing they ever heard. The darkness played here years ago. They said, the only thing they said all night, besides playing the songs for us, hello, we are the darkness, we're from the United Kingdom, and we're here on fucking business. That's it.
Yes.
That's all I said the entire time.
Awesome. What else is there to say?
Let's go to our business.
Yeah.
Go get it. Thanks a lot.